How are we doing, everybody? It's good to see you. We have a jam-packed day today. I've gotten in the routine of doing double streams because there's so much I want to play. I'm sorry for all of you that were looking forward to Monster Hunter today. I understand that. Monster Hunter is great. I have not lost my enthusiasm for Monster Hunter. But as I said during the Gears of War stream and the Paper Mario stream, that's right, I want to have some coverage of games more quickly. It's something I want Easy Allies to improve at. And Dragon Quest Builders is great, and it just came out today! It just came out yesterday. But I was gone yesterday, so I couldn't stream it yesterday. I've lost all concept of time. And so I'm streaming it today, so you can see it. I think it's wonderful. I am going to be doing a review of this game. It's not just Dragon Quest. It's not just Minecraft with a Dragon Quest skin. It's really something special. I can't wait to show it to you. But enough of that, let's get to the cacti. For those of you that have been following along, last time Godfrey and Cedro were playing Monster Hunter and leaving me out of it, and basically being too cool for school, and just, you know, being jerks, but they saw me playing Dragon Quest Builders, and they got into it, and they watched me play for a couple of hours last night. And it was a bonding experience, and we kind of soothed whatever was troubling us before, and so that was really nice. Let me know, guys, if the audio is all messed up, and I do want to say, before we get started, I am going to be doing Monster Hunter again next week. I might even do it, like, tomorrow or Friday, if I have some time, but for sure next week, I'll be doing more Monster Hunter, for those of you that want to see that. Here we go. Oh, yeah, and, somebody said Weeb Hour is starting early. I'm doing Dragon Quest Builders and then going into Yakuza 3 to 5. So it's a lot. I'm throwing a lot of information at you. But here we are. We're in Dragon Quest Builders. Let me get my headphones on here. This game, I haven't had a game make me this just happy. Like, I'm playing it just because of how it makes me feel. So it's probably like Animal Crossing New Leaf. Very similar vibes where it's just super, super chill. Really charming. Like, the charm through the roof. Okay, so you can build kind of whatever you want as you acquire items and get recipes and things like that. But what I love about it is there's actually a story and there's characters and they're, you know, they're simple, but they're still well written. And they have some really interesting things to say. Like, this guy has an ancient book that has secrets about the land that you're exploring. But he's also a bit of a doof and a bit arrogant. And he thinks your face is weird. So, you know, it's games like this where you kind of have a lot of creativity in what you build don't have the script and the characters and the charm that Dragon Quest Builders has, and that's why I love it so much. My town is really shitty right now. It's awful. I'm just kind of plowing through quests, because I am trying to review this, and I also thought maybe I could save, like, some of the more fancy stuff for the stream. We can really fret over about how things look. This is a basic room. It's just got two beds and a torch. I've got my workbench over here. And what's cool is as you acquire new villagers, randomly they'll go and they'll build things for you and they'll put them in your chest. Or they'll go and they'll cook things for you and they'll put them in this chest, which is in this room. So this is a crude kitchen. Then I've got my forge over here. This lets me build things with metal, like a copper sword. And then I have this teleporter. This is pretty sick. I can go to a different, like, island where there are she slimes. The last thing I did last night is I made a crude dressing room, and so this lady, who was in nothing but rags before, changed into this cute little dress. It was nice. And this is her room. This is her room. I gave her the biggest room. I don't know why. I just did. So yeah, I have a quest right now. Oh, first I have to learn a technique. So this warrior, this guy who's been helping me fight monsters, said, hey, go and defeat this giant silver scorpion and it'll teach you a move. And so I did that, and now I'm going to turn in the quest. KT90 just subscribed with Twitch Prime. Oh, I'm missing a bunch of stuff. All right. Sorry. A lot of explanation. KT90, thank you so much for the support and that you use your Twitch Prime subscription on us. Means a lot. Really appreciate it. Here's a ton of Sophies. And Brad. Brad's freaking out. He can't handle the Dragon Quest hype. There you go. And I also missed Heartfire subscribed 7 months in a row. That is a long time. I love you. I don't know how else to say it. Here's some Sophies and a Dirty Don. We're starting early with the Dirty Dons today. That means this stream is gonna go off the rails. Bildrick. Yeah, my name is Bildrick, which is weird. So you're saying it built up its energy, then spun around really fast. So that was what the Silver Scorpion did. It had this move where it would kind of like charge up for a second and then do a circular spin. Like a Zelda spin attack, basically. Alright, then let's give it a try. First, you build up your energy, and then... release! Ooh. New move. This is the first new technique I have outside of like simple horizontal slashes, so this is nice. He even does like a Zelda, yeah, when he spins. That's pretty cool. What happened with Monster Hunter? So I'm switching Monster Hunter with Dragon Quest Builders today. I might stream more tomorrow or Friday. I might do Monster Hunter then. But if I don't, I'm definitely doing it next week. Brilliant. It looks like you got the hang of it already. I reckon this skill will come in handy for gathering a lot of materials at once, too. That's true. You've got to store up your energy and then release. That's how you unleash this special attack. Cool. So I'm assuming I just hold... You attack with triangle, which is a little weird, but it's fine. Yeah, look at that! We got a new move. Alright, I'm pretty into that. And so I have another quest. Who gave that quest to me? Oh, it was, I believe this guy's name is Rollo? Is that right? Yeah. So, monsters come and attack our town at night, and so he wants us to get a stone stockade so we can better defend ourselves, and so that's what I'm gonna do. Cool. So in this game you don't earn experience for... killing things. You level up your base. My base is at level 2 right now. And as I put new things in it, make new rooms, that sort of stuff, it grows and expands. And occasionally when you complete quests, you get like a life seed, which will increase your maximum health. And then obviously as you go to new places, you find better materials, you can make better weapons and armor. So that's kind of how you get stronger, in lieu of like traditional experience. Oh, I have to go... What am I doing? Whoopsies. Okay, I've got to go back and go through the teleporter. So far, combat has been a little underwhelming, but it almost doesn't matter because of how good the loop is. Like, this game makes just running and doing things so much fun, and there's enough... charm that it sort of turns the mundane into something more than that. If that makes any sense. Alright. So this is the other place. This is the cool-ass teleporter that we got to use. It's got she slimes, which is neat, and they give you stuff. It let me make this adventurer's outfit. It's pretty cool. Okay, so there's nothing in the chest. I got a blue orb before. That, like, shows me... Here, let me... So the blue orb... Like, a special location is shown on your compass, so you can just, like, kind of run off and go chase after it, which is neat. Good old Hammerhoods. There's materials that I left. There's, like, a... Leader Hammerhood up here. He taught me how to make a giant hammer. And look at how adorable these guys are. Just bobbing in rhythm. Or bobbing in unison, I guess I should say. You have a health meter. You do have to eat. And you have to... You can either gather food like these plums, or you can make food like these... The shrooms on the stick, or the eggs. And, normally I don't like food meters in games, but it's really not too tedious here. as you would expect, much like Minecraft, when night approaches, enemies get a little bit more intense, ghosts chase after you, things like that. But I'm still early on, so it's not, like, insane. I haven't died yet, but maybe we'll change that today on the stream. Wait, where's the stone stockade? I have to find a way to cross, I think. I really wish I had known that each level was separate before I bought it, otherwise... Because I was assuming I could make a whole kingdom. Yeah, I understand that. I do wonder how... Because this game is also on Vita. I wonder how limited it is because of that, if they had to scale some things back. Again, I don't know. I'm just theorizing. Took a little bit of damage, but it's fine. Alright, so I've never done this quest before. I'm not even sure if I'm going the correct way. It's getting a little hard to see. I don't have a torch either. Ooh, what's this? Ooh, it's like an outpost. So this is, I just found this. I can rest if I want. If I put a block here and there, it becomes a room. So in order to make a room, it has to be two blocks high and in a square, basically. So let's gather some earth. Oops. Let's use our cypress stick since it's almost out anyway. Your weapons have durability. So you want to save, like, the powerful weapons for the big nasty monsters. You know? Alright. Cool. Alright, so that's enough earth. For those wondering, there is no multiplayer to this game. It's kind of like a single-player RPG. Which I really like, but... You know, I can understand why people would want multiplayer. Alright, so this should be a room. Or maybe it was just already acting like it, I guess. No, does somebody else own this? Inside a proper room. Oh, it's still... Okay. I missed a spot. How is this not a proper room? Okay. There are two... I don't understand. Hmm, that's weird. There we go, okay. We got it. All good. So we'll sleep and make it day, so it'll be easier to see. My monsters won't be as aggressive. We got it! We'll also use this earth to just kind of build a staircase. I'm always reminded of Catherine when I do things like this in this game. Making a stairway out of blocks. So I can't collect that. I'm gonna need more earth. More earth. Yeah, I'm gonna need more earth. You can destroy that crate and paper in the room and decorate your own town for more points. That's a good idea. Let's do that. I have a giant chest now, so anything... Like, my inventory is full, my pouch is full, but any extra that I collect will be sent to that giant crate in town, so that's good. More earth. giant chest Craig has them, yes. Alright, so that fell apart. Look at this hammer, though. Giant mallet. There we go. Alright, finally up. We've got some Chimeras up here. They're not too bad. They can shoot fireballs at you, which does a lot of damage, but the fireballs are pretty easy to dodge if you're not terrible. So no guarantees. Alright, got him. Got him. I love the little sound they make when they die. Stair Building Simulator, yeah. We figured it out, though. Alright, so he's casting a fireball. He hit the side of the rock, which was dumb. There we go. I'm excited about this stone stockade. We can, as we get more things like brick and stone and iron and all that stuff, we can actually make our little town look like a Dragon Quest town. Like, I have shop signs and an inn sign, and I'm excited to make that stuff. Look at that castle in the distance! Is this worth getting? I love this game, man. I was having so much fun playing, and the only reason I stopped is because I wanted to save some of the early stuff for the stream. Yeah, look at this castle. I'm excited. Okay. Might as well get this stone while we're here. What secrets will we find? Yo, this Chimera. This Chimera needs to chill out. The skeleton needs to chill out! Alright, we got him. Get some more plums. Oh, look at this dude! Hello. Hello, warrior. Alright, hold on. I got some monsters on me. I have failed. I've failed so terribly. Words faileth me in expressing how terribly I have failed. This guy failed. Doubts can see me? I was once a knight of Catlin, charged with defending these lands from the ceaseless advances of the Dragon Lord's armies. So that's something else I should say that I, as a longtime Dragon Quest fan, I absolutely love about this game. So this Dragon Quest Builders is actually set in an alternate timeline of Dragon Quest 1. In Dragon Quest 1, you're given a choice to either join the Dragon Lord or resist. Obviously, you're supposed to resist and kill him and save the land. But this is if the hero chose the other route and did choose to align himself with the Dragon Lord. And so you're kind of, you as the legendary builder are set in this world that has been ravaged by the Dragon Lord and the hero. And you have to repair that, which I think is just such a brilliant setting and gives this game like outstanding context. So, cool thing. This is the Knight of Catlin, charged with defending these lands to the ceaseless advance of the Dragon Lord's army. And yet, mere moments before I could complete the stockade that might have saved this castle, his forces fell upon us. My failure haunteth me to this day. Ah, but if thou canst see me, all is not lost. I can pass on the secret of my invention to thee. Here, friend, take these stone wall blocks and spike traps and complete the stone stockade upon which we stand. Dude, you got it. Oh no! Oh no! Okay, so I didn't know this was going to happen. I didn't know he was going to give me these things because my pouch is all full. I have to actually return to town to get the blocks and the spikes because I don't have them on me. They went to my giant chest since my pouch is full. It's okay. I have a Chimera Wing, and we already built stairs, so it shouldn't be too hard to get back to where we were. But, yeah, that's unfortunate. I don't have to return? Press X and go to items? Wait, what? What? Well, it's too late now. I've already returned. I should have waited for chat. Oh, no! You're totally right. I did not have to do that. That was a mistake. Well, it's okay. We can put some things away, at the very least. Chat, you tried, yeah. But my stupidity overwhelmed you. Alright, well, we have what we need now. We'll fast track it. I actually learned the same lesson the same way. That's good to know. I'm not the only one who made that mistake. Perfect run destroyed. We're not gonna get the world record anymore, guys. But yeah, I knew I was gonna like this game from my time with the import version, but some of the things that it does are so smart and have surprised me so much that I love it even more than I thought I was going to. Climb down this ivy, didn't take any damage, pro gamer. I should enter AGDQ with Dragon Quest Builders. That'd be hilarious. Wait, how did I even do this before? I see what happened. Okay. We need more earth. Back to Stair Simulator 2016. It'd actually be easier if I just did this. Here we go. No problem. Alright. These monsters are freaking out. Just want to help this guy complete a stockade. Ben, what do you think about the lack of permanence this game? Once you build your town and finish the area, just move on to the next. Everything you build essentially doesn't matter. I hear you. I think that's a fair point. The way I view it, though, is it's like my purpose right now isn't to just build for my own satisfaction. I mean, that's definitely present in the game. But my build is to save this land. Like, I am a character in this universe. Like, I'm not just... This isn't just some avatar for me to get my Lego on. Like, I am a person on a specific quest doing a specific thing. So I guess under that context, it doesn't bother me so much. Plus, there is a free build mode. But if it does bother you, I totally get it. But that's the thing, is that's why I'm not spending so much time laboring over my town, is because I'm kind of viewing it as an RPG where I do expect to just kind of move on at some point. Alright. Screw you, ghost. Alright. Let's finish this guy's stockade. There we go. 'Tis done. The stone stockade is complete. Now we have naught to fear from the Dragon Lord's minions. Go, friend! Lure those three hammer-wielding fiends into our trap and return to my side to see the stockade do its terrible work. Okay. Alright, so I want them to take damage. Come over here, dudes. Yes! Look at that. Stockade doing work. Do I even have to swing at them? Can I just... come back over here. This is great. They're just killing themselves. We'll finish this last one off here. We did it! We got some fur! Poor slime. Haha! That went wonderfully well. While the monsters strike in vain at the hearthstone wall, they soon fall to the sharp spikes beneath their feet. A cunning trap, dost thou not agree? I dost thou agree. Beg pardon, to whom doth the castle behind us belong? That building is no mere castle, but a bastion that did protect our people from the monsters. After the fall of Catelyn, the men and women of the city fled to this place and built this fortress as a final refuge. They did barricade themselves inside in a bid to escape the monsters' onslaught. However, it was not long before an even greater enemy emerged within the bastion itself. But forgive my ramblings, some tales are better left untold. Should thou seeketh a blueprint for this stone stockade, I bid thee speak with Ranulf? It's an interesting name, within the castle. I thank thee, kind stranger, for thine aid. Now that my plans are complete, I can finally rest in peace. Alright, so we have to seek out Ranulf. I want to name a tabletop escapade character Ranulf. What's up, man? It was all in vain. Well, 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 so thou canst see me, It seems thou art no ordinary man. I am Ranulf, erstwhile mayor of the city of Catelyn. But that was hundreds of years ago. Now I am a ghost. Woo! Do you guys like my ghost impression? Ah, so thou art the builder of whom the Catelyn Chronicle spake. Spake. I don't know if I've ever said the word spake before. Well, builder, what business hast thou in these ruined halls? The people who once dwelt here did bring destruction upon their own heads. Thou wilt find not here, but grief and sorrow. I see, thou comest in search of the stone stockade. Tell me, builder, why dost thou build thy city? It's getting really hard to read this. Old English, why dost thou build it all? Bildrick. Why did I name him Bildrick? Come with me. There is something I wish to show thee. I shall await thee atop the roof of this castle. But be warned, this staircase is have long fallen to ruin. Thou mightst need to build your own way there. Okay. You know what that means, guys. More Battlefield Earth. Give me the earth, please. All of the things. Alright, so the staircase has long fallen to ruin. That's fine. But is there like a good starting point? Oh, I can sit. Dude, what up? I'm gonna fix this castle. Just you wait. Here we go. No problem. And then, let's see. How do I want to do this? Oh, it won't let me. Okay. Is there something above me that I can chop down? Yeah, there is. Okay, so I can. No? Maybe not. Can I destroy this brick? Yeah, I can. Eh. There we go. Cast a wall block. We did it! Wait, where is he? Where are you, old man? Whoa! No! Okay, that was scary. That was scary. Okay, that needs to stop happening. There's a chest over here. I wonder what's in the chest. Better be a mimic. Is there anything over here? No. There's another ladder leading down. Let's go down. Actually, no, that's just, there's nothing down there. There's no reason to go down. Why would I do that? Strip castle free loot? Yeah. I think I might just polish up this one. There's already so much in it. Ben, break the roof? Why? Why do you guys want me to break the roof? Yeah, this music is really sad. I agree with you. Bye, Kaylee. Thanks for joining. There is falling damage, yeah. You don't even have to fall that much to take damage. Where did he go? Where did the old man go? I don't understand. He said, come to the top of the castle. I did. But I don't see him. What am I missing? I broke some of the roof for you guys. Old man is playing hide and seek with you? What? He's in the corner. This old man is a jerk. I'm gonna tear up his castle because he's being a jerk. Oh, there he is! I see him! Ha 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 ha! Well met once more, young builder. Now look upon the lands thou seest before thee. Look upon the sky and the black and brooding clouds that shroud this world. He's so serious. Once this world was blindingly beautiful. Its people lived beautiful lives in beautiful cities that they built with their own hands. Now all has been lost. Mankind lies bereft of all hope, perilously awaiting their inevitable end. Dude, is this Ian? Like, Jesus. Bildrick, if thou art truly the builder, thou must needs drive the darkness from the sky and bring back beauty to this land. Well, mightest thou quail at having such a weighty responsibility thrust upon thee. responsibility thrust upon thee unbidden. But know this, thy companions are in dire need, and the power to save them is thine and thine alone. Dwell not on thy city to rebuild this ruined world. Think only of aiding those around thee. By each small act of kindness thou shalt draw ever closer to thine eventual aim, just as block by block thou buildest thy city. 'Twould seem my prolonged response has not dulled my oratorial skills. Come, Bildrick, openeth, that's hard to say. Thou this chest, within it thou shalt find what thou seekest. Fare thee well, young builder. I look forward to seeing the brave new world thou wilt usher forth. Give me that boss key chest. The first defensive design. Alright, let's go back to Rollo. You know what that means. Chimera Wing. A good goodbye. Hey Ben, how's the sun/moon event? That's not where I was. I wish I was there. That would've been awesome. I don't know if I was allowed to, if I'm allowed to say where I was, unfortunately. All right, Rollo. Have you guys ever had the Rollo candy? The chocolate with the sweet caramel center? I really want some Rollos. Ah, Bildrick, you return, and with information about the stone stockade, no doubt. Quickly, quickly, let me see what you found. Fascinating, absolutely fascinating. I say, Bildrick. I am both a raving idiot and a mad genius for coming up with Bildrick. Something looks rather different about you today. You seem focused, somehow, as if a great weight has been lifted from your shoulders. Yes, you named it, Killstriker. I was at an NX reveal event. Bah, it's just my imagination. Your face is just as dopey as it's always been. This guy's kind of a dick. I love it. But anyway, well done, lad. All that's left now is to decipher these ancient papers. Thanks for the fucking stone. You can't give me a better reward than that. God damn it, Rollo. Alright, I'm gonna deposit some of this stuff. Do you have Rollo yogurts in America? They're horrible. What is a Rollo yogurt? I don't know what that is. Maybe we do, but I definitely don't know what that is. I now need to Google Rollo yogurt. I should eat. I'm gonna sleep. Nothing beats frozen Reese's. Frozen Reese's are very good. I'm gonna say I like frozen Snickers even more though. Like regular Snickers is good. Frozen, or even better than that, the special, like, you can buy them in packages, ice cream Snickers. Like whatever day you're having, if you have an ice cream Snickers, it's suddenly like, all right. It's turned upside down. All right then, Bildrick. I've been poring over those papers you brought me, the ones concerning the stone stockade, and I finally deciphered them. Judging from these documents, you're going to need plenty of stonewall blocks and spike traps. You'll need a blueprint to get it looking just right, of course, but you can leave that to me. Your job, Bildrick, is to work out how to build the stonewall blocks and spike traps. Once you've figured out the recipes, you just have to lay everything out to match the blueprint. Don't go thinking you know better, boy. As for its location, I suppose we should build it to the west side of town. The monsters always seem to attack from that direction. Okay. Hup, 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 hup. Stone stockade blueprint. Okay. Okay, okay. Alright, what do I need for spike trap? Oh, I've got that, I've got that. Okay. Build a stone stockade. I see. Okay, so Got it. Here's what I'm gonna do. I need another giant mallet. Okay, we'll put that there. That'll be fine. That'll be fine. Okay, so we need how many stone blocks? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I don't know, a shit ton. We need a lot of them. Okay, and we need a lot of spikes. Okay, okay. I'm assuming I'm gonna need more than this, but let's just lay this out for right now. Build an amazing town for Peppa, she deserves it. Peppa is amazing, yes. Yes. I do wanna do some better designs. Oops. I already messed that up. There we go. Building makes me feel good. Okay. Yeah, we need a lot more. So that's about half. So you need 20, it looks like, if my eyeball estimation is correct. Don't forget you get to build the Baron's quarters. Oh man, we should build like a Heaven's Bird recreation. That would take a lot of work, but it'd be fun. Can you build a windmill in Dragon Quest Builders? Whoops! God damn it, Ben. No. You keep doing that thing you don't like. All right, I need more copper ingots. Yes, yes. It's got to be 2 blocks high. That makes sense. Because the stockade I used on the other island was 2 blocks high. Yeah, any structures need to be at least 2 blocks high, it seems like. Which is cool. I love when they give you a blueprint and you just kind of follow it, because it just reminds me of building Lego sets as a kid. There's something kind of soothing about it, you know, like putting together a puzzle. I guess there's more thought required in putting a puzzle together, but yeah. You know what I mean. Alright, so for more copper ingots, we need more copper and we need more coal. Because we need more than 10 of these, right? Yeah. Good thing copper and coal are really easy to come by. Yeah, so we need some more spikes. What's up, Pepper? You like your room? I'm sorry it's so boring. I'll work on making it better. I promise. See you later. Press L1 and R1 and just hold triangle, Ben. It's easier to build like that. Okay. Yeah, I remember them saying something like that in the tutorial, but I couldn't remember what it was. And so, thank you. Oh, I need another wooden mallet. I need another wooden mallet. Because mine is almost gone. Didn't even give her a bathroom. I can't build a bathroom yet. It's beyond my capability at the moment. I don't know if you could ever build a bathroom. Alright, what do I need again for a mallet? Giant mallet. I have it, so let's just build it. Oops, nope, it's... Okay, equipment. Okay, we're good. Room, more like prison cell. Crazy Jackrabbit just subscribed with Twitch Prime. Thank you so much, Crazy Jackrabbit. I'm gonna give you a bunch of Sophies and Kyle Bossman. He's saying, thank you. That's my best Bossman impression. I hope you enjoyed it. Okay. Copper and coal. There's some copper and coal. Look at that. No big deal. Just gotta get rid of this spooky skeleton. Halloween month, everybody. Yeah, this music is glorious. It just makes exploring, like, even more soothing than it already was. Kyle Bossman sneaking up behind Sophie, I don't like this. Yeah, we can't let it happen again. Give me that copper. I don't remember how much I need, so I'm just gonna grab a bunch. I can look, I suppose, but I don't need to. There's enough here. Famous last words. Hitting stuff with my hammer. Oh god. Unintentional. Double kill right there. Let's see. We've got 10 and 5. We probably want like 10 and 10. No. Stop it. You dirty scoundrel. There we go. These guys, they just keep one. Oh, it's a big one! Oh no. Alright. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Why you gotta be like that? There we go. Dude, that's a kill streak on these materials. Alright, cool. That's probably enough. Blame the Dragon Lord. Always blame the Dragon Lord. Build a stone circade. I'm working on it. Just settle down. Okay. Yes. Good. Yes. Good. Okay. I've got so many spike traps. They're gonna freak out when they see the stone stockade. This is the best stone stockade they've ever seen. Yeah, you get him. I'm not gonna. Alright, move off the stone stockade so I don't. You don't take damage when I put this down. Please? No, don't walk on it. Come on now. Come on! What? Just move to the right! There you go. Oops. Thank you. All right, we did it. That was good celebratory music. Do I not take damage from this? Nice. Maybe my own people just don't take damage from it. That would be helpful. Okay. Oh, you think the floating ghost doesn't get damaged from the strikes? I thought they did in the other island, but that was a different enemy. I love how he just comes to my aid. You are a true friend. Alright, Rollo. Let's do this. By my elegant elbows. Good localization. You've completed the stone stockade. Those monsters will be in for a rude shock next time they attack us. Oh, I can hardly wait. Why are you excited to get attacked? You're a freak. By the way, Bildrick, while you were putting together those new fortifications for our town, I was hard at work gleaning even more secrets from the Cantlin Chronicle, and I learned something quite remarkable. The monsters of Cantlin do not merely roam this realm willy-nilly. They are under the control of a great and powerful monster. Yeah, the Dragon Lord. Only by defeating this fearsome fiend can light be restored to this land. Bildrick, my boy, we know now what we must do. We must continue to strengthen our town's defenses to fend off the monster's increasingly aggressive assaults. But as we do, we must also add to our own arsenal weapons and armor that we might one day defeat the monster's leader. The stone stockade you build is but the first step on our road to victory. Good work, Bildrick, good work. I should deposit some of this garbage. By my glorious elbows. Alright, so somebody, I want to actually practice this. We always need earth anyway, so I might as well grab a bunch of it. So somebody said hold. I think you meant hold. Okay, so that's how you build fast. Haha! Learning. No ghost. Stop. Wait, do I do a spin attack with a hammer? Ooh, nice. Of course. Alright, Rollo. Oh, not Rollo. La Roche? Hello there, Bildrick. Having fun with all your little building projects, are you? How condescending. I'll tell you right now, if you're thinking of building the city even bigger or making weapons to fight the monsters, I'm dead against it. I'm not saying it's not fun to build things, and if I did say that, I wouldn't not be lying. It's just that the workshop you've built for us is so dark and dreary, it's really draining my will to build. If it was just a little bit more inviting, I don't doubt I wouldn't quite feel so well. Not negative, but to sum up, Bildrick, I think the workshop needs a leather sack and a sconce in the wall. Okay, that's easy to do. It could also do with the shop sign hung up there, too. Wouldn't that make it a perfect place to work? Okay. So demanding. We have a leather sack. Yes, we do. I don't know why you need a leather sack on your wall. I don't think that's super appealing. But there you go. You creepy old thing. Alright. Sconce. I need to make a sconce. Sconce it up. Alright. There you go. And then a shop sign is what he wants, right? Yeah. right there. This is a shop. Wait. Improve the workshop. I did it, didn't I? Does it have to be on the inside? Maybe it has to be on the inside. Yeah, there we go. Stonemason Studio. I want it to be on the outside, but that's fine. Whoa, he's really freaking out about this. All he says is not bad. He wouldn't be alive if it wasn't for me, LaRoche. After doing that, you place the forge in the same room to make a blacksmith. Okay, I should just make this room bigger. Like, I should just chop this down and, like, expand it. It doesn't look half bad. Yes, I think this is much more conducive to my style of work. I dare say the town might sell my benefit put a forge in the workshop, too. Look, Bildrick, I can't deny that all these tools are useful, nor can I deny that living with your friends isn't entirely intolerable. I hate this guy. But there are more important things at stake. I realize I am repeating myself here, but I insist that you exercise caution. If your building works draw the attentions of the monsters, they will destroy you. However much Rollo may try to tempt you, you must not expand this town any further. Should your hubris get the better of you, it will summon forth a force beyond reckoning. The very same monstrosity that laid waste to Catlin once before. The Golem. I want to fight the Golem! All he gives me is wood? I hate you, LaRoche. You were the worst thing to ever happen to me. Alright, so yes, the Stonemason Studio is destroyed. Calm down. We're gonna rebuild. Oh, I destroyed the... That's fine. Oh, wait. Actually, I want to keep you... there. And then break you down like that. Yes, yes. Yeah, so we're gonna put the forge in here. We're gonna go right to the edge of our, like, light grid. Like so. Oh, we need more. No, we have earth. Thanks for the building tip. That makes it so much easier. Okay. Actually, I'm gonna need to move this pot. Oh no, that's a leather. Okay. No. I thought that was a pot. It was not. Okay, alright. We're gonna hang you here. Gonna put the pot here. The forge should be able to fit in that corner, right? That'll look good. Ish. That'll look goodish. The gold standard. Alright, sweet. Get at Rollo, god damn it. Do I have to get rid of this leather sack? Slack is so stupid. Ooh, we got 700 points for that? Yes, we're level 3! We did it! I think you can make a roof. And it fades when you enter a house. That's pretty cool. We leveled up. That's all that matters. With the stone stockade keeping the monsters at bay, we can finally concentrate on making Catlin great again. Okay, Donald Trump. However, I've noticed that you've had your hands full lately, tending to the various whims and whimsies of your townspeople. It seems you haven't had much time to focus on your own building work, so I'm giving you free rein to build whatever pops into that funny little head of yours. You build new rooms, furniture, even just some place, replace the walls of your current buildings with something a little more durable. You practice your building skills and become a better builder than ever before. In doing so, you bring the city another step closer to its glorious revival. So go, Bildrakt, do what you must to take this town and your building skills to another level. By my illustrious locks, the city is... I already did it, I'm already level 3. By my illustrious locks, the city is looking better than ever. Your building skills are just as the Cantlin Chronicle describes. That's how good I am. Give me quest. Quest already done. But Bildrakt, my boy, you still have a long way to go. It is near the time for you to seek out one who can bring out even more of your powers of creation. The Cantlin Chronicle describes a legendary blacksmith who went by the name of Magog. Okay. Though Magog lived many hundreds of years ago, it seems his descendant is still alive somewhere. Ooh. If we are to stand any chance of defeating the monster who rules this land, we must find a way to build even stouter walls and stronger weapons. If anyone knows the secrets of forging such items, the scion of Magog may be our man. I'll gather all the information I can about him and let you know as soon as I've tracked him down. When the time comes, Bildrakt, I hope I can count on you to do your duty. Seed of Life! Yes, good. More HP. I need to eat. Cool. All right. So we have to... Our next quest is a fight quest. I think my copper sword's in good shape. I have 10 healing cream. Should be alright. Now that you guys mentioned a roof, I want there to be a roof on this place, but... I just don't know. Oh, leather armor we can make. Okay. Yeah, we want that for sure. Cool. +4 to defense. I'm into it. Although it doesn't... doesn't look as nice as the Wayfarer's clothes. It's alright. By my knobbly knees, Bildrakt, I have terrible news. It's pretty good, Rollo. Seems the monsters plan to attack us again in even greater force. We do have the stone stockade on your side and stronger weapons than before, but still, we must not let our guard down. Be sure our weapons and unguent? What? I have never heard that word before. Are close at hand and be ready to face the enemy down. So, Bildrakt, are you prepared to battle? I think so. Hopefully we don't die. I should have saved. I love this transition so much. What a good call. Alright, let's fight. Alright, where are they coming from? They're coming from the north. Let's do this. Come on, warrior friend. Help me out. You missed. I missed. No hammerheads, not today. Oh, this battle music! Alright. Where are they? Some brownies appear, okay. These things barely hurt me. This leather armor was nice. Nice, nice, nice. Yo, get out of my town. Oops. Oh, look at this thing! Dude, Huber's coming and attacking our village. Why is Huber being such a jerk. We did it. I think you put the blockade on the wrong side of town to use it for these fights. It told me to put it on the west side. Am I... okay. Did I misinterpret that? Yeah, I think I did. I did totally put it on the wrong side. Oh well. My hacking and slashing skills are too strong. Yeah, okay. So it does... okay. Alright. It's bothering me. We gotta fix it. I just assumed that that was west, which was silly. Then if you listen closely, the knight was shouting, "I mean no harm. He was attacking my village, I couldn't let it stand." Ben, create stone colding and use it near dirt blocks you placed, and it turns them all into stone in 5x5. That's cool. Alright, sorry I'm rebuilding this. It shouldn't take too long. Just a couple minutes. Yes. So they usually come like right in the center here, so this will be fine. This will be fine. Got him! Whoa, what's attacking? Not cool. I build the stone stockade, they immediately just like run past it. No big deal. Whoops. Whoa, this thing is stronger than other ghosts I fought. That's not good. Oh, that was good. That was a good hit. Alright. Cool. Where did I must have missed picking up a spike. Back here. Yep, I did. There we go. I need to rest, too. I gotta go buy a bottle of wine and some chocolate if I'm gonna survive the non-stop streaming tonight. Be right back. That sounds wonderful. I would totally be down for some of that. Drinking wine and playing Dragon Quest Builders? Having some chocolate on the side? That's a jolly good time. Alright, let's rest. Oh, we got a new friend! He's just a little guy. Hello, new friend. I will protect you. Alright, phew, finally made it. I found the source of the light. Look at all these beautiful buildings. Right? I'd heard the rumors, but I'd never imagined it would be anything like this. Hold on. You didn't build this whole town yourself? I did, actually. But that would mean you must be him, the builder. Great goddess above, this is incredible! I can't believe I'm meeting the real live builder in the real live flesh. So, you're rebuilding the ruins of Cantlin, are you? The city that was once washed over by the giant golem. Really want to fight the golem. My name's Sheridan, by the way. I was traveling the world for a long, long time before I finally found my way to this place. I know I don't have much to offer, but I'd gladly tell you of the lands I've seen on my way here. I can't say how much you could make use of information like that, but I'm happy to tell you all I know. Sorry with you. I'll sell in straight away. Yeah, make yourself at home, dude. This place is for you, me, and everyone else. Don't sleep in my bed, though. There's no multiplayer of any sort in this game. This is a one-player game. Look at the back of the box. One player, one lonely dude. But hopefully there's Dragon Spillers 2, and there is co-op, at the very least. And then, if we're lucky, maybe online co-op. Images begin to form and build your mind. Okay, so I love this. I think it, like, flashes you back to scenes from Dragon Quest 1, which is really cool. Really, really cool. Or, yeah, kind of, anyway. Would that I might pass all the remaining days of my life alone with my beloved. Yet the knowledge that a monster might rob us of this simple joy at any moment weigheth heavy upon my mind. I like him. But all shall be well when thou defeatest the Dragon Lord. So they're speaking to the hero. They're speaking to Loto. Godspeed, you brave adventurer. To be alone with my beloved is to forget all that threateneth this world. But alas, I cannot put our plight entirely from my thoughts. For my lover informs me that were our world to be destroyed, our love too must surely perish. And yet, I know in my heart that we shall soon be redeemed from this peril, for thou art the scion of Erdrick, hero of legend. She beats trunks with brown hair, yeah, pretty much. When dark doth spread across this land, light shall return by Erdrick's hand. So, in the North American version of Dragon Warrior, Dragon Quest I, the hero was known as Loto, but in... Wait, or was it the other way around? It was Loto in one region and Erdrick in another, but now they've made it uniform, and it's both Erdrick. I believe the Japanese version is Erdrick. That was my dear, departed grandsire's favorite phrase. I believe the Japanese version is Erdrick. Almighty goddess, we pray that the ancient teachings hold true. May thy light shine upon brave... whatever quests. I'm glad you like tabletop, BDYMS. Biddums. It seemed like a memory of something, and I'm glad you enjoyed it too, is that Alucard? A lot of good vibes today, I appreciate that. Seemed like a memory of something that happened long, long ago. But whether it was his own memory or somebody else's, Builder can't remember. What's so great about this game and the idea of setting it in this alternate timeline in Dragon Quest 1 is Dragon Quest 1, you know, is obviously a very, very, very simple story. And by kind of playing with it, it makes it feel more fleshed out and more important. And I think that's really, really cool. It builds upon it, the legend, in a neat way. Alright, we should save. We should definitely, definitely save. Sorry, guys. Just reading chat, catching up. Should I get this or World of Final Fantasy? I've only played World of Final Fantasy for a very little bit, but... I don't know. I was going to try to offer an opinion one way or the other, but I just don't know. Hopefully we get our copy of World of Final Fantasy soon, and I can let you know. I love... In a way, I think this is maybe a little bit more creative than World of Final Fantasy. Because it's sort of taking Dragon Quest and putting it in something completely new. Oh my god, monsters! See, now they're coming from this side. Do they always come to where the stockade isn't? Double kill. Actually, it was a single kill. By my elegant eyelashes, Bildrick, my boy, you found another teleport. Toll? Another teleport? A fortuitous find indeed. I was just talking to our new friend Sheridan, you see. He told me where we might find the legendary blacksmith I mentioned earlier, or rather, that blacksmith's descendant. And it seems the island where this man was last seen is on the other side of that very teleportal. If you could persuade that smith to join our town, there's no end to the mighty arms and armors we could build. Excuse me. Now, be sure the new teleportal is firmly in place, Bildrick, and go track down that man. Okay, so I think I want to put the new teleport, Toll, right next to the old one. So I'm going to expand this a little bit. Actually, yeah, so I want it to come here. Cool. And then you go. Yes! Take me away to a distant land. Twin Teleportarium! That's fun to say. Getting more points? Not bad. Alright, we should just accept all these quests at once, right? Yes. Peppa, come back. Pippa, not Peppa. She should have a sister named Peppa. That'd be pretty cool. Well, Bildrick, now that you've got the new teleportal, you can go to a whole new island. You know, I've been doing a lot of cooking lately. I'm itching to try out some of the new recipes I've dreamed up. For example, I thought I could stuff some chimera's beaks with plumberries and grasshoppers. That sounds horrible. And then boil them up in a mixture of earth and blue goo. But when I told Roland my idea, he said that he'd die if he had to eat something like that. So, Bildrick, I was wondering if you could show me one of the new recipes you've invented, something that tastes really tasty, but doesn't make you die. I know you're really busy doing things for Rollo and everyone else, so I don't mind if you can't help me straight away. Pippa, I will always help you first because you are the nicest. Does anyone else have a quest? Are there new recipes that I have for cooking? Fruit salad? Boiled butter beans? So what exactly does she want? Does she want... Stop! How do you hop? Stop hopping over walls. Oh, okay, so maybe I have to go find a chef. He said that there's this place called Damdara on the other side of the Red Teleportal where a super famous chef used to live. I bet if you found him, he could teach you all kinds of amazing recipes. The kind of food I want to make is something that doesn't just fill you up, it makes you feel full of energy too. The best way would probably be make something really fulfilling and then put a big bit of meat inside. Okay. Okay, so we gotta go find the chef. Are there any other quests? I wonder if I could just hop on top of my buildings. Alright, let's go to this new place! I'm excited. More headhunting. Yep, we're going to find some new... new monsters. Okay. Alright, let's... eat a little bit. I don't remember what the unicorn rats are called. Whoa! Not today! Chunk of meat! Bunny corn, okay. That's cool. Alright guys, be on the lookout for a famous chef. I'm just making everybody mad on this Damdara island. I don't know how much of the meat I need. Oh, I got hit. No, no, no. Did you guys see that sick dodge? He didn't drop anything, though. Alright, so usually when you're, like, close to somebody, you can see their speech bubble. They'll try to talk to you. Oh my god. So many monsters! All of the monsters. I'm taking way too much damage. There we go. We got a new sub! Shelburn. That's meant to be Shelburn. I'm sorry. Just subscribe with Twitch Prime. Thank you so much. I hope you're enjoying the Dragon Quest Builders and the soothing atmosphere it provides. I'm gonna give you 5 stars. And some Sophies, because you're 5 stars and Sophie is 5 stars. Look at that, that worked out nicely. Oh, I want this cactus. Golems! Look at the giant golems! I wonder how difficult they are. Let's heal a bit. Oh, I do no damage! Oh my god, I do no damage! Okay. I do no damage. Oh god. Okay, I do 1 damage with the mallet. That's... Alright. Peace out, golems. That's not good. No, golems, please. I just want to talk to that guy! Oh my god. They're pretty fast, too, for being giant things of stone. Please stop chasing me. I can't. Please stop. There's that cook I need to talk to if I wasn't getting chased by golems. Can they jump? Thankfully, it doesn't look like they can jump. Alright. Are they done? Are they done being jerks? Okay. Alright, I think we've gotten rid of him. Cool. What's up, chef? Thou canst see me? How very unexpected. 'Tis a rare one indeed that I can see a denizen of the spirit realm such as I, so he's part of the spirit realm. What manner of man am I? I was once a culinarian of much renown. I created the most sophisticated dishes, unlike aught the realm had seen before. The pinnacle of my work was the invention of brick barbecue. Alas, I never did get the chance to share my ingenious idea with the world. The enticing aromas of my very last meal attracted a band of roving monsters. With my dish of spiced plumberries not enough to satisfy their hunger, they slew me. Be wary, traveler. With great cuisine cometh great danger. Oh, shit. Getting both of them with that charge attack seems to work pretty well. Haha! Ooh, I got a scorpion horn. Pro gamer. Thou hast slain the monsters? 'Tis a pity. I was hoping to offer thee a waiter's role in my special restaurant. But since thou canst see me, mayhap there's another role thou mightst fulfill. I bid thee assume my mantle, carry on my legacy of culinary research, and make use of the secrets I did uncover. Go out into the land of the living and become the greatest culinarian in the world. Absolutely. What sayest thou? 'Tis an offer few would refuse. Wilt thou become the one and only head chef of Alifgard? You bet, man. What? Thou art too busy building your town, building to turn your hand to anything else? No, I want to cook. Come on, game. Bah, thou art a fool. Dost thou not see that cooking is but another form of building? 'Tis not simply a matter of filling empty stomachs. Each meal bringeth hope and happiness to the hearts of those who consume it. Hi, Rem Mariam. That's how you say your name. How are you doing? Shouldest thou truly hope to save this world, I urge thee to continue my work. I shall teach thee how to build the brick barbecue. Protest all thou might, but thou shalt be taught. I prithee, allow my genius to aid thee in thy quest to make Alifgard rise again. See ya, B-Boy, and thanks for hanging out. Brick barbecue. The brick barrier focuses the flames to create an ideal toasting temperature. Ooh. Alright, so let's look at recipes and see how I make this thing. Cream of mushroom soup. I love soup. The things you get excited about in, like, games where you make things. Oh, I can make soup! How cool! I need a cook fire. Okay, I need a brick wall, an iron ingot. Okay. How do I make those things? I don't know how to make iron yet. I don't think. But I think if I find that that blacksmith for the other quest, that will resolve itself. I don't want to piss off these golems. Ooh, what's up with this lady? We have a friend for Pepper. Or not Peppa, Pippa. I keep calling her Peppa. It's not her name. Alright. Oh, it is Pippa! What are you doing here? Ah, so Rollo sent you here to look for the blacksmith, did he? And you came running straight away, I suppose. Honestly, that weirdy beardy's got you working like his own personal dog's body. Dog's body? Rated M for mature. You want to know what I'm doing here? Hey, Bildrick. Why don't you leave that lazy old geezer behind and run away with me? What? Dude, romance? Social link established? The truth is, everyone back in Catelyn really gets on my nerves, and I just can't take it anymore. The Pippa, this isn't you! Come on, Bildrick, run away with me. Let's start a new life together, just the two of us. In hell! Plot twist of the year. No! What have you done with Pippa? Oh, you charge! Okay, I didn't know you charged. I did not know that. You do a decent amount of damage. I'm gonna try to stay away from you. Oh. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. OP. OP, OP. No, why are there so many monsters all the time? Okay. I can jump better than you guys, though. You can swing better than I can. No! Alright. I gotta... Maybe just slashing might be better. Not like this. Not like this. We're gonna be okay. We're gonna be okay. Bait the attack. That's right. I did it. Oh, and I got a key. That's pretty cool. I can make glass. That's gonna be useful. Alright. Harrowing fight, but we're okay. Let's eat in celebration. No! God damn it. Alright, give me the key. I wasted the food. Accidentally. Whoa! It's fucking Law! What's up, dude? Huh? Who are you? Seeing as how you made it in here, I take it you got the better of that guard. But more importantly, what are you doing around here in the first place? I'm looking for you, man. Huh, building your own city, are you? And you're looking for a certain blacksmith to help you out. Then you're in luck. If you want a blacksmith, you've come to the right place. I'm Magnus, heir of the legendary Magog. But let's save the proper introductions for later, eh? You can tell me all about this town of yours when we're there. Excuse me again. Lead the way. This is so Law. Look at him. Look at his glorious pectorals. And that clap! I love it. Okay. Alright, let's go back to town. You're gonna teach me things so I can make this barbecue. It's very important. Whoa, they're all super stoked to see him. That's cool. Kor, did you build this whole place yourself? No doubt about it then. You're that boy they was always telling stories about, the legendary builder. If you don't mind, I'll make myself at home. I ate anything special, but I'll help you whatever way I can. There's just one thing what bothers me. This land you're building on. This is where the old fortress city of Cantlin used to be, isn't it? You think it's true what they say, the place was pounded in the ground by a giant golem? Yo, this is super jolly. It is the most jolly. What's that? The golem didn't destroy Cantlin, it protected the place. Well, it happened hundreds of years ago now, so I suppose we'll never know what really happened. I bet we find out. The story I've heard was passed down by the survivors themselves. I can't see why they'd lie about a thing like that. Anyway, seeing as how you're the legendary builder, and I'm the descendant of the legendary blacksmith, I should probably teach you the secrets of making iron arms, like what my father taught me, and his father taught him. Of course, you need plenty of good iron to get started. If you're running low, the Minbara Desert is full of this stuff. We definitely need iron. Yes. I need that iron broadsword. It gives me a huge bonus to attack. Sledgehammer! Now we're getting into real weapons. I love it. Iron armor. Good, good, good. Shield. I'm gonna need so much iron. Okay. Come on, Rollo. By my bad back, you've done it again, Bildrick. You've brought the blacksmith back to Cantlin. What's that? You met a monster that looked just like Pippa, and she was guarding Magnus's cell? It was just as I feared. The monsters are watching her every move. How else could they have known about Pippa and myself? No doubt they captured Magnus expressly to lure us into their trap. These fiends are not to be underestimated. We wish to double our defenses. But before that, good work, Bildrick. If you're not already done so, I recommend you speak with Magnus and learn from him everything that you can. Alright, Seed of Life is good. Alright, Rollo, what else you got for me? doing? Oh, we got monsters. Bildrick, I've been talking with Sheridan, our resident traveler-in-chief. He tells me that the land from which you rescued Magnus was thus known as Demdara. Yeah, you call it the Demdara Desert. He also tells me that a vast wealth of treasure is hidden within the Great Pyramid that stands there now. Great treasure, you say? The Cantley Chronicle mentions ancient fire-breathing statues called evil idols, and Sheridan assures me that they form part of the monster's horde. If we have those statues, we can build an even stronger circade with which to defend our town. So go, Bildrick, for the sake of the town and its continued safety. We get fire-breathing statues? This is great. Okay, so it's saying you need strong weapons to do this. We're going to have to make the other stuff first. Let's go to our workshop here. Whoa! Monsters. Warrior friends took care of it. Okay. So... Iron for Ring Cord. Okay, so we just need iron, basically. We have everything else that we need. Cool. Rollo has other plans in the shadows. He's scheming against me. I hope not. I hope not. Rollo creeps me out enough already. Alright, let's make some sweet new weapons. Ben, is this good? I think it's great. I think this is a great video game. That is so low. I just can't get over it. Okay. Back to Demdara. What does the iron look like? I'm assuming it'll be pretty obvious, right? Just like the copper and the coal was? Do I have to, like, dig underneath? Digging down scares me. Yeah, I think I'll just run into it. Like, maybe it's just over here. We'll see, we'll see. Alright. Yeah, okay, I see the iron. I got it. Is this scorpion not gonna leave me alone? Wrecked. Ooh, I got chains? They can drop chains? I don't know how I feel about this. Okay. Good. Okay. Give me that. I need a lot of iron. I'm gonna need way more than this. Oh, there's some more. Speak of the devil. I should get, like, 30 iron, right? Grind it out. Hopefully that doesn't take too long. Oh, okay. Alright, you wanna play that way? Sometimes I always step just a little bit closer. Sometimes I step closer to them than I think I'm going to. So Ben, Tokyo Mirage Chest is Dragon Quest Builders, which is Goaty. Both are very, very good. Both are very, very different. Maybe it's just because I'm in the moment with it right now, but I think I might like Dragon Quest Builders just a little bit more, again, because it's such a cool spin on Dragon Quest that, like, that novelty hasn't worn off for me. Tokyo Mirage Sessions is excellent, and the battle system is really cool. It has a lot of personality and style, but, you know, it is kind of cut from the Shin Megami Tensei cloth with some Fire Emblem elements. I don't know. It's a tough question. They're both very good. They're both worth your time. I've forgotten how enjoyable it can be. It's probably not that enjoyable to watch, and I'm sorry about that, but just like running around and picking stuff up is like in a game like this or in Minecraft. There's just something about it that's very relaxing. I feel so calm right now. Like, this grinding doesn't bother me one bit. Ooh, look at that. I bet that's where we get the evil idols. That's the pyramid they were talking about. That's cool. Is there fire over here too? No, not that I see. Okay. Alright, yeah, so iron is not difficult to find at all, which is good. Good, good, good. Use the spin to mine. Yeah, I mean, it doesn't take that long to hit it, but, like, never mind. That is by far the superior way to mine. Thank you for the tip. That is so much better. Wow. Yeah, I should have been doing that from the beginning. Wow, wow, wow. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's so good! Oh yeah, it saves so much time, you eat so many items. I love it. Alright. Gonna get 30 iron and then go back to town. Oh, look at this. Look at this! So much iron here! Oh yes, iron for days! I love it, okay. 27. I have kind of dug myself into a hole here. We're fine, oops. Like this, and then like that. My hammer's almost broken, my mallet. All right, we've got enough iron. I'm running low on Chimera Wings. I'm sure I can just craft more. Yeah, I'll just craft more. It's fine. We'll take the lazy way out. Are there spiders in this game? Not that I've seen. So, you know, so far a good video game. Okay. We have so much iron. Iron, 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 iron. Time for some smelting. Yes, indeed. I'm excited about this. We're gonna make all those weapons. Oh no, I don't want to use a Chimera Wing. Wrong thing. No, I. Why do I keep hitting square? I don't know. I don't know. I don't know anymore. Obviously, this game is Minecraft. Sort of. There's definitely some similarities to Minecraft. Very, very direct and obvious comparisons. But it's more focused. It's like Minecraft if Minecraft were more RPG-ish, I guess. Quests are kind of the focus. Ornamental swords. I like some ornamental swords. We're learning so many cool things. Ornamental armor? Alright, great. Iron broadsword. Sledgehammer. Yes. Iron armor. Minecraft story mode, Kappa. Exactly. Nailed it. I just built all the things. This is great. Okay. So just to make this easy, I think I'm going to de-equip a lot of this stuff. So it's easier to cycle through. I'm gonna make you naked real quick, Bildrick. Don't worry. I will remedy the problem. There. Dude, look at me. I am ready to go. This looks like a hero right here. Yes. I love how, like, I'm worrying about how I look, and the warrior guy is, like, killing monsters for me. It's great. Okay. Brick barbecue. What do I need for this? I need brick wall. How do I make brick wall? I can make brick wall! Jump button X just subscribed with Twitch Prime. Thank you so much. I hope you're enjoying the stream. Here's some lovely Sophies and a Blood Wars. Even Blood is enjoying Dragon Quest Builders right now. I don't know why I said even Blood, but I did. Okay. We need a cook fire. We need a bonfire. Bonfire. Got it. Cook fire. Brick barbecue. All right, cool. I should expand this a little bit, I guess. Excuse me, I'm gonna sneeze. I guess, do I need... Excuse me again. Do I need the cook fire if I have the brick barbecue? I don't know. I'm gonna put both in there, because I just don't know. Oh no. I'm destroying everything. I want it all to be earth. I don't want it to be not even. That's gonna drive me insane. Takeout. will expand you a little bit. No, wait. I went too far. What am I doing? And then I actually, I'm gonna expand it even more. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do that. So let's take this down. I'm sorry guys that I'm tinkering with this. My OCD is getting me a little bit. Okay. Yeah, so we'll expand you out. Put you there. Yes. And then I can actually push all this stuff back. Oh my god! Here. Put this in the corner. Yes, look at that! Alright, then we need a light source. I want to put the chest back in there. Where did the chest go? There it is. Put the chest in the corner. Like so. Barbecue kitchen! They're excited about it. I'm excited about it. Everybody's excited. Alright, and then let's build... Let's build... This... No, I want a sconce. I've never said that in a video game before. I would like a sconce here, please. Okay, and she wants me to make crazy new stuff. Right? What does she want me to make exactly? I don't know. I don't know what she wants. Maybe sometimes they want three of something, so... Make me a meal of meat and wheat. Of meat and wheat. Meat and wheat. Does anybody in chat know what she wants to eat? You need to go pick up some wheat. You must have missed it. Okay. Maybe that'll give me like a new recipe. Okay. Alright, I'll go pick up some wheat. Meat and wheat is a classic meal. Exactly. Okay. Oh, hamburger! That's what she wants. Okay. That's cool. This must be wheat, right? This looks like wheat-ish. No, that's sandgrass. That's not wheat. Okay. That is clearly not what wheat looks like. Just because it's a grassy thing, does not mean it is wheat. You want to play this so badly? Rightfully so, man. It's super good. Wheat is taller. Yeah, yeah. I was like, I knew that. I really did, but I didn't know if that was like their stand-in for Wheat. But of course not. Okay. I need a wheat field, please. Looks at grass. I think this is wheat. Yeah, I know. I know. It's pretty bad. It's pretty bad! I know what wheat looks like. I just thought maybe that this was the game's version of wheat. We're in a fantasy land, after all. There really is no excuse. Any tips on finding wheat? We're running out of time for the stream, unfortunately. But I want to give Pippa a burger. She's been waiting so patiently. You need to go to the mountain area past the Hammerhood place. Oh, okay. Dang, okay. Not in the desert, right? But in the, because of course there wouldn't be wheat in a desert. There's definitely wheat in Iowa. Am I gonna have to end this with no wheat for Pippa? Do you guys want me to find the wheat real quick or get started on Yakuza? I don't care either way. I was remember it was in the mountains on the way to the castle. Alright. Ghost. Calm down. Alright. We're gonna get started on Yakuza, I think. Ben only knows corn, not wheat. Oh no. I'm never gonna live this down. Like most of my life. Alright, let's save. That was a ton of fun. I can't wait to play more of that tonight. Oh, such a good game. Maybe I'll never find wheat. Maybe the review will be indefinitely delayed because I never find wheat. You need wheat closure? Alright. Alright. I'll keep going until I find wheat. Settle down, Ghost. What? You're sleeping in my bed. God damn it. Everything's falling apart. Everything's falling apart. You should mention wheat in the review, but tell Brandon to edit grass in instead. Yeah. I should do that. It'd be really funny. Or I think it would be really funny. Alright. We're going to get wheat! Ben, why don't you just build a wall around your town to avoid the monsters getting in your bed? Because we don't have time for that. We have to get wheat. Have you not been paying attention? Build a wall and let the monsters pay for it. Give me that wheat, please. Okay, you said, somebody said by the mountains there was wheat. Is that true? There's silver down there. That's exciting. Where is the wheat? Maybe it's up past the mountains. Or the, on the mountains of the biome after, okay. On it. We already built stairs up here? No, we didn't. I don't think we did, not for this. Give me that wheat! There we go, that's wheat for sure. We got it. The thing about playing games like this is like, backseat gaming is always a problem during streams, but then it, like, during a stream like this where there's so many different ways you can do things, it becomes the worst. So much wheat. We were rewarded for our efforts. We finally have wheat closure. I need like a backseat Bosman wall. And that's grass. But we can make bread with it! Don't worry, we're almost at Yakuza. We're almost there. Oh, we're dying of hunger. Bunny Burger! Pippa, we're gonna make you happy before the stream ends. I didn't want to talk to you, I wanted to make your food. Yes! Yes! That's incredible, it is incredible. I had to make a great journey for this. Didn't he have wheat in the chest already? No, I didn't. That was the first time I had wheat. Eric, you gotta calm down, man. It's gonna be okay. Yay! Thanks, Bildrick. I'll eat it later. I'm not very hungry right now. Oh, and by the way, we invented an exciting new recipe. First, you take the skeleton skull and fill it with earth and Draki's tails and plumberries. You have the worst recipes. Then you boil it in a sauce made from earth mixed with orange oil. It's still working out the details, but I think it's nearly ready for Rollo to do a taste test. Alright. We've got fruit salad. Pippa is happy. I can now switch to Yakuza. Thank you, everybody, who watched for Dragon Quest Builders. And if you're only interested in Dragon Quest Builders, I understand. It is a very jolly game. But we're going to switch it up, doing Yakuza on the PS2. It's going to take me about 5 minutes to set up and do all that good stuff. But I will be right back. Bye, guys. Boop.